Tonight we are going to finish this cruise in style. Now, who saw my show last week?
Yeah.
We had quite many of you. Well, welcome back and thank you once again for being so amazing. And for you who did not see me, my name is Heidi. I'm from Sweden and I've been singing since I was a little girl, ever since my school teacher crushed my dream of becoming a snake. So now you're all up to date. The next song I'm going to sing was sung by Lady Gaga in the movie A Star Is Born. Has anyone seen that movie? Now, it doesn't only come with a fantastic soundtrack, it also has a very powerful story. It's a moving, thought-provoking story about two people trying to balance their relationship with their careers, with the added pressure of addiction and all the mental health problems that comes along with that. Now, it's a tragic story, but sadly, one that is all too familiar. Now, we all change when we get older. The way we see the world, the way the world sees us. Even in the most loving relationships, which I know that many of you are in, as I've seen you around the ship, gazing into each other's eyes, clearly thinking, I really hope that's my wife under that mask. You know, we go through ups and downs as we're trying to manage all the daily distractions that life just tug us around with. And it's really important to stop every now and then to really acknowledge those rare moments where we feel grateful, where the stars are aligned, the dots are all connected, where we just know that we're exactly where we're meant to be, romantically, spiritually, physically. But we know that it won't last forever because no feeling is forever. So we future-proof. We take a picture, we say something out loud, or we write something down just to capture a memory of it, so that we have a reminder of that brief moment in time where everything just seemed so right. Now, we might also look at our partner to acknowledge how perfect the moment is by asking them to do simply one thing. Always remember us this way. That Arizona sky burning in your eyes. You look at me, babe, I wanna catch on fire. It's burning in my soul. Opportunity to share my voice and share my story. It really means so much to me to stand on the stage doing what I love on your last night of the cruise. So thank you. Yes, and please keep those applause going for the production team and the orchestra. I wanted to leave you with something memorable, so I'm going to sing my last song in Italian. But don't worry if you don't understand the words, because the music is so recognizable and powerful that it transcends language. You see, I'm blessed to have friends from all over the world, and one who happens to be from Italy. So after many, many hours of practicing in a variety of bathrooms, I invited her to a rehearsal, you know, to see what she was thinking. Now that was a mistake. After singing my heart out, I asked, "So what did you think?" And she said one word, inappropriate. Now, I was a bit surprised because I actually thought my Italian was pretty good. Thank you for coming out tonight and enjoy the rest of the show.
Ti vedo, ti sento. The beautiful Italian language, you almost didn't notice it was the Titanic song, did you? Feel good now? Now, ladies and gents, variety all the way for you. Next, we switch over. That was our beautiful lady from Sweden. We're going to our Wales theme next. Brought here a couple of nights back, and we're bringing it back now for you, ladies and gents. It's the music of Tom Jones, and it's brought to you by David Kidd!
You don't have to be beautiful and turn me on. I just need your body, baby, and just till dawn. You don't need experience and turn me out. You just live it all up to me. I show you what it's all about. I think I better dance now. Welcome to the show. Now I thought tonight, you've seen Tom Jones, haven't you, already, the other night. Anyone come to the show? Yeah. Great stuff. I thought what I may do, can you start the track please? I thought what I may do is do something for the Americans in the room, because in England at the moment, we'll be right back. Hopefully we have a few Elvis fans in the audience.
Yep.
Of course we do. No, I don't know anybody that doesn't like Elvis. Really, really don't. And anyone seen the new film? Yeah. I've not seen it yet. Apparently it's phenomenal. It's number one in the UK at the moment in the cinema. So I thought I love Elvis, okay? Everyone thinks that Tom Jones is my favorite singer. Yes, I do like Tom. I do sound like him, so it's very, very easy to put the show on. But I would say if I had to sit down and listen to one person only, it would be Elvis. Ooh, definitely. Because he's same as Tom, he does everything. Plus, the good thing is, they were best friends, okay? And I've got loads of stories what Tom told me during the filming of The Voice of when he met Elvis. Some very strange stories. But we've not got time to tell them this evening. And one of his favorite songs is a song which Elvis recorded back in 1968. And what happened was, it ties really into the song Kiss, to tell you the truth. Because what happened was, Tom Jones is saying 1988, he'd been missing for quite a while. He was in Vegas and he wanted to get out of Vegas and do something different, you know, to other countries and Europe and back to the UK. So what he did, he decided to record a song which was Kiss. But he didn't know how the song would have been received. So what he did a very, very late program show over in the UK on Channel 4. And the presenter was a guy called Jonathan Ross. Do you remember him? Yeah, everyone knows him. So Tom went on there to do this new song, which was Kiss. But he took a leaf out of Elvis's book, because back in 1968, they both got talking, and Elvis was very, very aware that he'd been a missing for a long, long time, okay? Been in the army, been making movies. And he thought, well, how am I going to do this? So he put on a very small show, Elvis. But what happened was, people heard about it, and they were queuing up around the block to get in there. So he had to do an extra show, and they did some extra filming. They took the show into a big film studio, and probably, I would say, he did probably the very, very first music videos, big production music videos. Elvis was probably the first to do something like that. And in 1968, this song was on the comeback special, but it wasn't supposed to be on there. What happened was, he hired a group of guys and girls to do a gospel choir, okay? And he heard them rehearsing in the corridor, and because it had a good ambience. So he heard them and he thought, wow, what's that song? What a fantastic song. He went over to the guys and he had a word with them. And he learned that song over a couple of days during the filming. And that went into the show. And it's all about a guy called Martin Luther King, okay? Beautiful number. I'd like to say good night, everyone. Thanks to the guys once again in the sound and light over there. Have a very, very safe journey home, everyone, if you're going home. And hopefully I will see you again. Thanks to the band. There must be lights burning by them somewhere. Got to be birds flying higher in a sky more blue. If I could dream of a better land where all my brothers walk hand in hand, tell me why, oh why, oh why can my dream come true? Tell me why. Understanding sometimes strong wills of promise that hold the weight of a doubt and fear. If I can dream of a warmer sun where hope keeps shining on everyone, tell me why, oh why. With too much rain, and a time to request. And I'm not sure that the answer is somehow.
Singers, but who's not been on yet? It's a gentleman who many of you have been talking about after last night's performance, that you saw what happens when you give an adult too much sugar. Ladies and gents, he's going to have another low-key and relaxed performance for you coming now. What's about to happen? Don't really know. Never do when he comes on stage, but you've been warned. Please welcome back to the Princess Theatre stage, it's Gareth Oliver!
I've got to tell you, I can tell by the numbers in tonight that 30% of you have never seen me before. Yeah, it was quiet last night, but you were great. The people that weren't, who was in last night? Amazing, awesome. Well, who wasn't in last night? Why? Let me tell you, quickly, just for the couple of people that weren't in. Oh, I'll go, I'm going. Good night. God, that reminds me of when my granddad got cremated. That's horrible. Anyway, so basically, I was on Britain's Got Talent in 2009, narrowly beaten by Susan Boyle. I made a banana disappear as well, and I'm into cold water, and that's how I generally make a banana disappear. So listen, round the ship, I have been stopped by everyone. I've been sitting with guest entertainers up in the buffet, gathering material for the show. And I've been sitting there, and everyone has been coming up to me and saying about how great I was last night. It's good, isn't it? Every single person, hey, get this though. They haven't even mentioned the other guest entertainers that I'm sat with. Just me, saying you are fantastic. You are the best act on this ship. The best act I've ever seen. That's what I've been saying. Do you believe that? At least that's what the other guest entertainers think. You see, as a ventriloquist, oh, it's very easy. It's very easy. Every single person walking past in a mask, I'm just throwing my voice. It's amazing. It's never happened. No one recognises me. Because the thing is, when I'm not working, I tie my hair up. Because it avoids, you know, the awkwardness of getting my hair pulled and stroked. You know, she's one that does it down here. We've got a stroker in the house tonight. Are you one of those women that just like stroking things? Because if you are, my cabin number's 7964, okay? Don't go to cabin 7964, that's not my cabin, love, all right? That would be very awkward if you're knocking on the door and there's a man inside. I'll come give you a stroke. Don't do that, love, all right? So, a woman said to me the other day, she said, is that your real hair? She said. I said, yes, it is. She said, do you permit? I said, I don't need a permit. It grows out my head. I can park it where I want. She said, oh, I would, because women love men with long hair, you know, not the ones without homes. But she said, but women have stopped me in the street for years and they've said to me, I would do anything for your hair. You know, and it turns out they won't. But she said to me, she said, can I stroke it? I said, you what? Why do you want to stroke it? She said, because it looks so long and soft and, you know, luscious. I went, well, can I stroke your breasts? She said, what? No, you cannot stroke my breasts. I said, why not? She said, that's different. That's sexual. I said, maybe for you, love, you're 75. Not for me. See? Nothing. So anyway, I've got to say, we're all leaving tomorrow. I went to the buffet tonight. I thought I'll get my money's worth tonight, you know. I won't get food like this at home. And tonight, they are going all out. They had loads of those things in the buffet, those things, you know, the things on sticks? Old people. Oh, there were loads of them. And it's all right, love, they can't hear me. So, I have trouble getting into the buffet because you know that, you know the freestanding Purell dispensers? You know the ones? You have to know where they are because you've got to know what to avoid.